So I'm going to start with the with 1 John 4:4. You dear children are from God and have overcome them, because the one who is in you is greater than the one who is in the world.
Yes.
So I'm the type of person, I like to look up what words mean. I like to have accurate definitions.
Amen.
So I looked up the definition of the word power. And I found three definitions. The first one is the capacity or ability to direct or influence the behavior of others or the course of events.
Mm-hmm.
The next one I found is a right or authority that is given or delegated to a person or body.
Uh-huh.
And then the last one is a person or organization that is strong or influential within a particular context. So then I looked a little bit deeper and I was like, okay, if that's what power is, then what is superpower?
Okay.
So superpower is an excessive or superior power.
Come on.
So excessive capacity or ability to direct or influence.
Yeah.
So while I go through the rest of my message, I want you to think, what is your superpower? So your superpower depends on the gifts and the callings that God has for your life. So everyone has a different gift and a different calling. But God also has universal instruction that he has given to all of us. So Genesis chapter 1 verse 26 says, and God said, let us make man in our image after our likeness, and let them have dominion over the fish of the sea, over the fowl of the air, over the cattle, and over all of the earth, and over every creeping thing that creepeth upon the earth. Verse 27, so God created man in his own image, and the image of God, God created he him, male and female, created he them.
Amen.
Verse 28, and God blessed them, and God said unto them, be fruitful and multiply, and replenish the earth and subdue it, and have dominion over the fish of the sea, and over the fowl of the air, and over every living thing that moveth upon the earth. So when God gave me this